Howdy ho, H2O's roller bros and soul porters alike. I'm your guide Q, and welcome to my favorite stock image of all time. And also, you know, I don't work here, lady, and entitled parents. I just love this picture so much because, like, what have you done to our child that's using an iPad that's the size of his entire torso? Like, what is going on here? I just love the stance of the father, the looks on both of their faces. It's just absolutely perfect. But today, we are going to be looking at a few stories from I Don't Work Here, Lady, one story from r/entitled parents, and they're bangers, so let's just get right into them. This morning at the gym. Good morning, friends. I work at a tech company. Coworkers are aware of my account, so I will not say where I work. I was pumping some iron this morning wearing a shirt of my company. This woman comes up to me, actually similar in age to me, and starts going on about how bad her experience has been with us. It's important to understand that I don't work with customers directly. I work in quality assurance. Here's the convo.
Hey, I have a bone to pick with you.
I'm sorry?
Your company? That shirt you're wearing?
Okay, what's up?
The service I've had with you guys has been just awful. People don't show up when they're supposed to, and it's just been a mess.
I'm sorry to hear about that. Have you tried contacting our customer support team? They're available 7-7 every day.
No, I haven't, but that's fine, because you can help me.
Not really. I have none of your account information, and even if I did, I'm not in customer support, and I don't have the tools to assist you at the moment. Call customer support at 7, they'll be on and ready to help.
Well, it's your company, and you're here with me right now. Just help me. Tell me what's going on.
Call customer support at 7, they will.
So you're not going to help me?
I can't do anything to help you right now.
Unbelievable. When I do call in, I'll be telling your manager about you.
Enjoy your workout. This guy, one, doesn't even work in the department you're looking for, and two, and most importantly, he's off the clock. Like, if you go up to people that are off the clock and ask them for help with whatever their company does, it's just such a scumbag move. It's like they're not trying to think about work right now, and he can't even help you even if he was at work. So, like, just stop, go away, get some help.
I ignored your daughter? Alright, I'll pay for gas then.
Okay, this happened about a year ago, so the details are a little fuzzy. I was 24 at the time, a little on the chubby side, medium length, blonde hair, and I couldn't fight my way out of a wet paper bag. This will be important, I promise. I used to work at this gas station by the highway, and I was there for about 3 years before being fired. I was fired 1.5 years before this happened. On my way to a date night with my boyfriend of 3 years, I decided to stop for gas and to check in with some friends who started working there. They were rather busy that afternoon, so I pumped my gas and walked in to grab a coffee. Now, the workers there wear a red shirt with the logo stitched on, black business pants, black shoes, and some wore a red hat with the company logo. I was wearing a red knitted dress, tight black suit pants, and heels. I can see where an elderly person with bad vision can mistake me for an employee, but not a young, fit, teenaged girl and her brainless mother. Anyways, I was getting a small coffee when I made a little bit of a mess. Being that I used to work there, I automatically started cleaning the mess, restocked the paper towels, and checked the creamer. The store owner was in the back, and she had never minded if I helped out a little when it was busy like this. I'd finished cleaning and put a lid on my coffee when I hear someone from behind me asking where the chips are. I don't really know where they are anymore because the layout of the shelves has been changed since I left, and I'm a bit of a health nut, so I don't care for them anyways. I thought she may have been speaking to an employee close by, so I ignored her and walked off to the sodas to get my BF his favorite drink. Apparently the person behind me was the teenaged girl and ran off to tell her mother I ignored her. As I'm grabbing my love's soda, I feel a hand grab my shoulder and yank me around. I don't remember exactly what was said, but it went something like this.
Who the hell do you think you are ignoring my daughter like that?
Excuse me?
I asked you where the chips were, and you ignored me!
I don't know what you're talking about. Let me go. I backed up a little to get away from the mother's grip, and she yanked me back. I was able to pull her hand off of my shoulder, but it took some great effort on my part.
Yes, you do! You were cleaning the coffee station, and you ignored me!
At this point, it was finally clear to me that they thought I worked there. I don't work here! I made a mess, and I cleaned the mess. Doesn't mean I work here.
Yes, you do! You're in uniform! I want the manager now.
Being the sneaky bitch I was, I decided to have a little fun. Tell you what, I'll pay for a full tank of gas and we can forget about this whole thing.
Well, that's more like it.
She turns with a victory smile and walks off. The daughter humphs at me and follows. I pay for my coffee, my gas, and soda. They won't turn on her gas because they haven't paid yet.
I then walk out to my car that's parked close to hers. All paid for, just give them a few minutes. I don't have all day, and why are you leaving? You need to pump my gas. An employee will be there to pump your gas in a moment. I have a business meeting to get to. Please have a wonderful day. Whatever, just see to it that it's done. I smile at her and drive off to my date. Found out from the manager that after an hour of standing there, she finally came in and screamed at them for not turning the pump on. She even said that I promised to pay for her gas. When she was informed by the manager that I didn't work there and I never paid to have that pump set, she threw a hissy fit that would make toddlers seem like little saints. They banned the lady from the store because she had started throwing things around the store. They had to call the cops and she was escorted out. TLDR, I ignored a teenager, got attacked by mom, and lied about paying for their gas as revenge. Cops were called and I made it in time for my date. Okay, let me first just say that it's never right to put your hands on another person, especially how hard this entitled woman was gripping on this former employee's shoulder. Like, that's ridiculous. Regardless of if somebody's an employee or whatever, it's just never right, and it is assault, so the cops totally could have been called here for that alone, but then she ended up doing destruction of property. Now, as much as I'm on the side of the woman that used to work there and got harassed by this entitled mother, I also don't know if it was the best move to promise this woman free gas for revenge. Because then the gas station just has to deal with that whole thing of this woman being confused about why she's not getting free gas. I don't know. Let me know if you think that was a good move or not. I know it does annoy this woman, but I just feel like it annoys the gas station unnecessarily as well. I also don't believe that this woman was sitting around for an hour waiting for someone to pump her gas. Like, when you're entitled like that, you want everything, like, immediately. So I have to believe that she would have run right back in that store to figure out what was going on. But anyway, let me know what you think. Let's get to the next story. There was a fire. No, you can't have a cheeseburger. I'm a fire investigator for insurance companies. A few days ago, I was at a fire at a super common fast food restaurant helping another investigator process the scene and dig. All of the fun parts of my job without any of the responsibility or report writing. It was so cold that if you farted too wet, your ass hair would freeze. That's the first time I've ever heard that. So I was in black coveralls with my black Carhartt and a baseball hat with a regular N95 mask because fires and fast food restaurants are gross, you know? Just for clarification, an N95 mask, I had to look it up, is like that standard face mask that you use when you're sick or if you're a doctor doing surgery or something like that. I looked in no way like a restaurant employee. Even with the black clothes, you could tell I was covered in soot and debris, and what restaurant employee wears an N95 that's been stained black? I was standing outside in the parking lot with another investigator that was there, and we were chatting, taking a break from being in the grossness from inside. The parking lot has been filled with debris. On one end of the parking lot, there's a 9-foot-tall pile of random burnt stuff. On the other end of the parking lot, in front of the drive-thru, are all of the roof ventilation systems that are half-burnt and melted in a big pile along with the whole assortment of burnt stuff. There's caution tape everywhere. There's fire debris haphazardly strewn throughout the area. There's a very visible hole burnt in the top of this building. There's a goddamn fire engine parked at one entrance of the building with a lot of their lights on blocking the entrance. There's no way to misunderstand what had happened to this building. A man in an old van drives by with his window down, slowly staring at us. He has this inquisitive look on his face. He drives past the first entrance, then attempts to turn into the entrance blocked by the fire engines. He backs out, turns around, and then turns back into the other entrance headed right for us. I say us. The other investigator wisely caught on to what was about to happen and whispered good luck and hauled the ass back inside, leaving me alone with Van Guy. Anyway, Van Guy drives around the big ass pile of ash and stops in front of me. He says, "Hey, what happened here?" I replied for what feels like the millionth time in my career, "There was a fire." He says, "Oh, what started it?" And for the millionth time, I replied, "That's what we're here to find out." He says, "Oh, okay, well, can I have a cheeseburger and a medium fry?" Trying very hard not to say what I truly wanted to say, which was some variation of, "Bitch, do I look like a fast food worker?" I told him that no, there was a fire and you can't have a cheeseburger. He then proceeded to ask, "Well, can I have a large Coke then?" Again, "No, there was a fire, you can't have a Coke." You know how you can see when someone has that moment where it finally clicks? This guy had it. He looks at me and asks very intently if I work there. I say no, I'm here investigating the fire. He then asks, and I'll never forget it, "So they're closed, but why?" Feeling like I've met the universe's densest star, I replied, "Because there was a fire." He finally just says, "Oh, okay, well, bye," and just drives away and out of my life. I'm still not sure he truly understood why he couldn't have his food. I walk back inside, and the butthole who had left me there to deal with Jacques Clouseau himself is standing there and just asks how it went. Because I work with buttholes. At first I thought this was just like some dad making dad jokes, like, oh, I see you got a burnt building there, any chance I can get a cheeseburger and fries, ha 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 ha, but then it just like goes on way too long, and I'm assuming, I'm not sure if the story clarified this enough, but I'm assuming this dude is standing outside of the building whenever is the fast food employee that you order from, unless it's like a car hop situation, standing outside of the building, like it just doesn't make any sense, how is this dude this confused? Entitled mother shouts at me because I saved her son's penalty kick. A bit of backstory, I played for my town's under-13 football club, and I played as a goalkeeper. The game where this all unfolded was the semi-final of the cup, and entitled mother's son, CK Cool Kid, was on the other team. The game finished 2-2, so we went on to penalty kicks, and this is where it starts to get interesting. After 4 kicks each, it is 3-3, and our team scores our 5th penalty to make it 4-3. So if the other team misses, we win. CK steps up to take it and hits it just to my right, so I stretch out my hand to save it. Our team starts celebrating, and entitled mother's son, CK, who to be fair was very nice and took the defeat very well, comes to shake my hand. Entitled mother did not like that and stormed over. She had the "can I speak to the manager" haircut, and she was in her mid to late 30s. The following conversation goes down. How dare you deny my son to score and lose this match? That's my job as the goalkeeper. Bull honky! She is literally screaming her lungs out at this point. The referee walks over and tells entitled mother to calm down. Who do you think you are? Ma'am, I'm going to have to ask you to leave this field. I'm not going to call it a pitch. I live in America. Entitled mother storms out in a huff, not before screaming at CK to follow her, which he does. Thankfully, after the match, our team got pizza and I didn't see entitled mother again, but I do feel really bad for her kid for having a mother like that. This happened 2 years ago, and I still get angry when I think about it. Oh my god, I feel so bad for this kid because he's so chill. He's like, yeah, I play soccer to like have some fun and also to play a competitive sport so that it can be challenged to become a better athlete so that it can compete at a higher level. And the mother's just like, nope, everything should be given to you. Everybody should just throw the game so that you can win every single time. I signed up for soccer so that you could win. Like, that's so ridiculous and over the top. So Bunky, let me know what you think about all of those stories. I really like including people's comments because I just want to like have people be surprised. Like, why is this video saying my name? I just love that idea. But anyway, let me know what you guys thought about all of this. You can find my social media links in the description down below alongside all of my Amazon affiliate links for the equipment I use. And the cool thing about those links is that if you click on them and you do other shopping on Amazon that's unrelated to those products, I still get credit for it. So that's pretty neat. I will see you guys soon. Make sure you're having an absolutely wonderful day. And yeah. Beast. It's like when a fat person is too lazy to say obese, they're just like, I am beast. I can say that because I'm fat. Anyway, see you guys later.